Over the next couple videos, we're gonna work on our custom map annotation that you see here on the screen. And we're gonna break it down into phases, right? First, we're gonna start off talking about drawing our custom shape that you see here, which is again, the general shape of the annotation. And then in future videos, we'll kind of build the overall annotation view, and then we'll actually like implement it into our map and add the navigation where if you click on it, you can see the detail screen. So that'll be the process of building our custom map annotation over the next couple videos. All right, onto the shape stuff. And to explain this, it's best to actually like write some code. So what we're going to do in views, in custom views here, let's open this up. I'm gonna right click, I'm gonna add a new group because we're gonna have a couple files in this folder called map annotation and do a new file in map annotation. We're gonna make this a new SwiftUI view for now, even though our shape is gonna be of type shape, not of type view. But for the explanation, we'll do a view for now. Hit next, map balloon, hit create. Okay, cool. Let me get our preview up and running because we're gonna need this. Okay, so SwiftUI has some built-in shapes, even though we're gonna build our custom one. I'll start explaining the built-in ones first. And we've already used these, right? When we use clip shape circle for some of our images, right? So let's kind of take a look at that. So circle, there you go. You see, we get a circle. Of course, we can like, you know, now adjust the frame of the circle, right? If we want like 100 by 100, there you go. And then, you know, instead of circle, rect, rectangle, there we go. And you see, we get 100 by 100 rectangle, which is actually a square. So you'd have to do like width of 200 by 100, right? And then we have capsule, right? There's a whole bunch of built-in shapes that you can use. Now let's click into this shape definition just to show you what's kind of going on under the hood a bit. Well, you see, this is the actual like capsule stuff. I actually want to option click into shape just to take a look at what it is here. So you see, it is a protocol, it's animatable, and it is a view. And if we read the overview, this first part is just about fill, not a big deal, but here you go. You can define shapes in relation to an implicit frame of reference, such as the natural size of the view that contains it. That's gonna be a big part of when we draw our shape, it's gonna have that container. So when we draw our coordinates, it's gonna be in relation to the container. That's the key thing I wanted you to remember. So let's get out of the definition here. Go back to our map balloon. Now let's draw a basic square just to get the basics of drawing down. And then we'll get a little more advanced with our custom map balloon shape that you see here. Okay, so the first thing on our map balloon, we don't want it to be a view, right? We want it to be a shape, right? And what I'm gonna do is get rid of this var body sum view because that's the typical like SwiftUI view. I'm gonna hit command B. Xcode's gonna say map balloon does not conform to protocol shape. So to conform to this protocol shape, right? We'll add the protocol stubs, right? We have a path in rect. So this rect is that container that we talked about that this shape is gonna be in. And this path is essentially what a path is, right? It's gonna be point A to point B to point C to point D, however many points we have, right? I just did 4 points because that's a square, right? 4 points. If it was a triangle, it would be 3 points, right? So that's what we're going to draw right here within our, you know, container. So to start doing that, we have to do var path equals path. So we're initializing a path object. Now our path object, we can add lines to it to draw it. So, well, we have to return path, right? That's what this does once we're done creating it, right? So right now we're just returning an empty initialized path, which isn't gonna show us anything. So I'm not updating our preview quite yet. So the first thing you wanna do is something called move to, which is like your starting point of the path. So we're gonna do path dot move to, and you see it takes in a CG point. We're gonna be using CG point a lot, which is just essentially a coordinate on the screen. So an X and a Y. Now you can use numbers like 100, whatever. I like to use like max Y, mid X, cause that's, you know, will be relative to whatever container it's in. So for this square, I wanna start in the bottom left-hand corner of our container. So I'll do rect.min X, right? That's all the way to the left of the screen. And then the Y, we'll do rect.max Y. And max Y, so you may think max Y will be the top. Well, no, max Y is the bottom. So the top is zero for the coordinates. So that's our starting point, right? So the next line we want, I'll hit resume, right? We should see nothing. Yep, there's nothing. So I'm gonna put some lines on the preview in post and edit so you can kind of see what we're going to do. So our starting point right now is in the bottom left-hand corner. The first line we wanna draw is up to the midway Y, to the middle of the screen, right? We wanna fill the bottom half of our container with this square is essentially what we're saying. So to add that, we do path.addLine2, and then again, it's another CG point. So the CG point, if we want to be on the left side in the middle of the container, in our case, it's the whole screen right now, right? That's rect.minx, right? Because we still want to be all the way to the left side of the screen. However, now it's rect.mid, not max Y, mid Y. So now we're going to the middle of our container with our first line. Now we're not seeing anything quite yet because we need more lines to make the shape, right? So the next line we want is across the middle. So the next point will be mid Y, but max X, right? Because we want to go all the way to the right on the X coordinate. So we'll do that path dot, and you'll see this show up now after this. Add line two, CG point, and then again, X and Y. So now the X is rect.max X, right? So now we want to go all the way to the right. And then on the Y coordinate, we're still mid Y, right? Because we're going right across the middle, mid Y. So now, there we go. Now you see what's happening here. We have a triangle, but here's what's happening, right? So we drew this first line going from the bottom to the middle and then across the top, but the path will automatically close, right? So what this line coming across the bottom here is it automatically closing the path so it's a complete shape. So once we add our third line going to max Y, again, bottom right, but on max X as well, now that's gonna draw this line right here and it's gonna connect across the bottom to see the square. So we won't actually have to add that last line that goes across the bottom. So we'll add one more and you'll see it autofill to create our square. So add line to CG point, and then X and Y. So again, right now we are at max X mid Y. So we wanna stay at max X, rec.max X, and now we wanna go to max Y. We wanna go back to the bottom, because remember max Y is the very bottom. I know that gets confusing with min Y being the top. I get that confused all the time. So we wanna go to max Y. And then now you see, because it drew that third line going from the middle to the bottom right, now it connected the bottom, now we have a square. So like I mentioned, our shape is naturally gonna fill whatever view we give it. And in our preview, we just said, do a map balloon in the whole view. So it's filling up our entire phone. Well, let's say on our preview now, we just did a frame of, we'll say 300 by 300, right? So now you can see we have a 300 by 300 square in the center. Let me add a border here for visuals. Border, yeah, color dot black, sure. So now you see on the right here, we have our border on our 300 by 300 square and our shape is only filling up the bottom half of it, right? Because that's how we set up our coordinates here. Okay, I guess I had a typo down here on the black, there we go. So that's the key thing to remember is that your shape, however you set it up, is going to fill whatever container you gave it. And by default, before we added this frame, our container was the whole screen, the whole view. So that's what it did, right? So let me actually comment out our frame modifier. You can see, like I said, it's trying to fill the whole view. When we give it a frame, it's only gonna fill that little bit. That's key in how we're going to create our custom shape. So again, that's basic drawing. Just started off with a super basic shape. Again, just think about it. You have a starting point and you're literally going point A to point B, point B to point C, point C to point D, or however many points you need by creating these lines. Now, these are just straight lines. As you're gonna see in our custom shape, we are gonna add some curves. And this custom drawing can get very, very, very complex. And there's actually a great YouTube channel that demonstrates all this called Code Slicing. It's a small channel, so I recommend go check it out, support it. But Adam there, he draws some crazy shapes. He takes this custom drawing to a whole other level. So if you are interested in custom drawing and all this stuff and you really wanna ramp it up, go check out that channel. But warning, it can get quite complex if you've never done any of this drawing stuff before. So now that we're done with our basic square, let's start on this map balloon custom shape that you see here. So back in our code, I'm gonna get rid of all this frame comment out. We're just gonna keep map balloon. I'm going to get rid of the path, the added lines that we had. So remember this path move to is our starting point. So the starting point for this map balloon, as you see on the screen, I want to be the bottom middle, right? See the bottom point of our map balloon? That's the starting point for our shape that I want. So back to our path move to, that would be mid X, right? And then max Y. Remember max Y is the bottom. So now our starting point is at the bottom of the screen, in the middle, it's exactly what we want. Now, before I add our curves, because this has to do with like control points and all that stuff, when it came to this drawing and these control points on these curves, I actually got this pretty quickly because I was familiar with it due to using design tools like Sketch and Photoshop, because it's the same stuff, you're just doing it in code. But if you don't have that design tool background that makes it easy to connect to what we're doing, let me show you that. So I'm gonna go to Sketch and I'll show you exactly what we're going to be doing. So I have an artboard here with an iPhone 12 Pro. I'm a little zoomed in just for the video, but you see that's the general shape of it. I'm gonna zoom back in just so you can see what we're doing. So what we're going to do when we add this curve, right? I'm gonna insert a vector here, right? So what we're gonna do, we're starting at the bottom middle, just pretend this bottom part is the middle, right? And then we're gonna draw a line to the top. That's how we're gonna start our custom balloon shape. However, when adding a curve, you have something called a control point. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come down here, grab an area on here, and watch when I drag this out. So you see, This right here, I'll put an arrow to it so it's hard to see, it's called a control point. So essentially what we're saying is on our shape that we're gonna draw, we have point A down here, point B up here, and then we're gonna have a control point, and it knows to draw a quadratic curve through that control point up to here. So you can see how our map pin is taking shape, right? And then we're obviously just gonna do the same thing for the right side of it to make our overall shape. So you'll see when we add our curve, it's gonna ask for point A, point B, and a control point. So that's what we're gonna do, a point A, a point B, and then our control point. And now if you wanna get more advanced, these little control arms right here, like you can really tweak, you know, the curve and everything. We're not gonna mess with this control arm type stuff. That is a bit more advanced, but I wanted to show you it existed. And like I said, when I learned how to draw like Bezier curves back in like UIKit and now shapes in SwiftUI, it clicked right away because I had a lot of experience in design, like creating stuff and using these control arms and control points. So once you kind of have this visual and then you see what we're doing in code, hopefully, you know, that starts to make sense. So, okay, back to Xcode now that the visual portion is done. Okay, so now we're gonna add a curve. So path.add quad curve, there we go. So remember I said we're gonna have a point, so we need the line, right? Because right now we're at our starting point, the bottom middle. So where are we going? We're going to the top middle, right? So CG point, X and Y. So we're still mid X, rect.mid X, because we're in the middle, and then we're at the top. So rect.min Y, remember min Y is the top. And then now I'll put this control point on the next line to make it clean. So now we need to put our control point. And again, back to sketch here, that's this right here. So this coordinate is where we're gonna put our control point. So the coordinate for that will be CG point, and we want rect.min X, because that's all the way to the left, that's on this left side of the screen. And then we'll do rect.min Y. So essentially what we're doing here is putting our control point in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. Now you can see it's starting to take shape. However, it's not exactly what we want, right? So let's add the right side of it before we talk about that. So the right side is basically a mirror image of what we did. So what I'm gonna do is copy the path that we just created, paste it there in our two parameter, right? Because right now we're at the top. We want to go back to the bottom. So the X is going to be mid X. We're still in the middle, but now we're max Y. Because remember, max Y is the bottom. So now we want to go from the top to the bottom. It messed up currently because our control point is messed up. So our control point is going to be max X, because we want this control point to be on the right side of the screen, max X. And then min y is the y, right? Because we want it to be the bottom. So now you can see it starting to take shape. Again, not 100% what we want it to look like, but we'll talk about that in a second. But let me review this shape, because I know many of you probably have never drawn custom shapes before. This was maybe all brand new, right? Path move two, that's our starting point. That's bottom middle. We're gonna add a curve to the point, which is the top middle. Now we're gonna add our control point, which again, back to sketch, is this right here, right? Except ours, I mean, sketch may not be perfectly accurate, but you know, ours is like, you know, up here, I don't know, I mess with my control arms. I probably can't recreate it exactly in sketch, but anyway, the point is our control point is in the upper left-hand corner of our screen, which is giving us the shape we have. So that control point coordinate is what we added here on control. And again, we did min X, which is on the left, and then min Y, which is top left, which I'll put a little arrow to it. And then the next path, we just kind of flipped it, right? We're starting from the top middle, so we want to go back to bottom middle, which is down here. And then we added our control point in the upper right-hand corner to give us this curve. So now remember, our path is filling up all the available space, right? It's filling up the entire verticalness of the phone that you see. Well, on our preview, let's give it a frame. Let's give it a square. So we'll do frame of, we'll do, you know, 200 by 200. And get rid of the alignment. Okay, so you can see, because it's now in a square and not a super tall, you know, rectangle, it kind of got squished down, right? And it's kind of getting closer to what we want. However, I had to dial this in because if you look at the design, right, we have that image in the middle of our thing, and then we also have the badge. So I needed to squish this down just a little bit more to get the shape I wanted. And actually in my notes, I had this 300 by 300 to start, not 200 by 200, just to make it, you know, more visible. And then the height I gave it was 240. And essentially what that did, if you look, it's like squishing the top down. Like, let me go back to 300. Right, it's, well, not 3,000, 300, right? So you see, when I make the height 240, it's almost like I'm putting my hand on it and like pressing it down to squish it a little bit, right? So that's what I'm talking about by, I keep adding the extra zero. The shape is going to fill whatever frame you gave it. And the last thing we can do, just for preview purposes, is give it a foreground color of dot brand primary. There we go, that's starting to look like what we want. So if you have questions about this, because again, I know many of you have probably never drawn custom shapes before, or maybe you don't have the visual design experience like this, so this may be all brand new to you, feel free to ask questions in the comments. But we are going to move on in the next video into using this shape to build the overall map annotation UI that you see here. All right, let's go.